Hey everybody, welcome back to the MacWhisperer Academy. I'm Dylan Stewart, the MacWhisperer, and in today's lesson, I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about using a green screen. Today's episode is very special because in today's episode, I'm going to let you see behind the curtain or behind the green screen. You see, a lot of people have started using virtual green screens with apps like Zoom that allow you to put a picture or an image behind you that isn't really there. And in one of my videos, I had a backdrop of an office with some old iMacs in it. And one of the people watching the video smartly asked me why I would have iMacs that were so old and whether it was an actual choice of mine. At first I thought, what is he talking about? And then I realized he was talking about this. He was talking about the background. Well, here's the reality. That's not real. At all. And I can change it to look like whatever I want it to look like this. Or this. And instantly, the background is completely different. So how do I do that? What's the magic behind using green screens? Well, first off, let's start by disabling the virtual background. Now you can see it for what it is, right? It's just a green screen. So let's get started. First off, let's get this bad boy down. Voila, my bedroom. It's exciting, isn't it? Kind of seeing like the secret, the magic. Here's the deal. I have what's called a retractable green screen that I'm able to put up or down very, very easily. We'll talk about that in a moment, but before we do, I want to show you some of the other green screens that exist. The first one is a standard green screen. Now let's take a look at how theoretically easy it is to set up one of these green screens. If I was really going to use this, I'd also have to bring out a little steamer and get rid of all of these wrinkles. Because as you see, if I turn on the virtual background like this, it doesn't look great. You can see all the wrinkles. So that's what a standard green screen looks like. They're not that expensive. And they come in sizes that allow you to do it very wide and very tall. And they're great, but they're very hard to put up and take down. And as you could see, this is my bedroom. So I can't have this big green sheet hanging up in my bedroom all the time, which means I got to take it up and I got to put it down, which can get exhausting. So after doing that for about 6 months, I decided there had to be a better way. Let's take this guy down and I'll show you one of the other options. So as you can clearly see, that was a lot of work. And if it takes that much work to put it up and down, you're going to say to yourself, is it worth it? So now there are some other options. We're going to talk about an option that connects to the chair you're sitting on. So let's take a look at what that looks like. Now, most people do their Zoom calls and other things that would require a virtual backdrop while sitting. So if that's your case, you might be interested in one of these guys. This one is called Web Around. It costs about $70, although there are cheaper versions out there. And what it is a green screen that sticks on the back of your chair. So let's see how this works. Over here, take this part, slide it over your chair like this. Looks funny now, doesn't it? But when I sit down and position it properly, let's see how it looks when I put a background behind me. So it's good, but not perfect. It wouldn't work if I was standing, it wouldn't work without the chair, and it wouldn't work if I were to just push the chair back a little bit, because all of a sudden you see the edges of it. It works, but not great. So let's go ahead and take it off and put it away so you can see how easily it goes away, and then I'll show you my third option. Comes off the chair. Folds up pretty quickly. And it's definitely portable. And so now let me introduce you to option three. It's what's called a retractable green screen. It's about 5 feet wide, a little bit more, a little bit less than that, which makes it portable, but not super convenient to carry around. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and place it on the floor. And it comes with a pole. The pole stores inside of it. It has a little slot on the base for the pole to stick in. Pull the pole up to the desired length. In my case, I want it all the way up because I'm standing up and I'm a fairly tall guy. And there's a little handle that you have right down at the bottom. You pull it up. Here's the green screen. It hooks up onto the top like that. And in a matter of what, 30 seconds, I can do this again. We can go to the beach like this. Go get ourselves a Mai Tai, kick back, or maybe we want to go to outer space like this. I know it's cheesy and it's silly, but the ability to be able to put a backdrop allows it to look like you're in an office instead of in your bedroom. So you can see how easy it is to use a retractable green screen versus the two other kinds. Now let's take a look at Zoom and let's look at what happens when you have a green screen versus when you're using a virtual green screen. A lot of people complain about the virtual backgrounds. They say they keep disappearing in and out of the image. That's because you're not using an actual green screen. You're letting your computer pretend that there's a green screen behind you. So let's hop over onto the computer and I'll show you what it looks like without and then with a real green screen. So let's start off by opening up Zoom. Let's go ahead and start a new meeting. Now down in the lower left corner, you've got your camera options. I'm going to click the little arrow that you see to the right of the video camera right here. You got a bunch of options here. One of them says choose a virtual background. So let's go ahead and do that. As you'll see down here, there's a little checkbox that says I have a green screen. We're going to leave that unchecked right at the moment, but I'm going to go ahead and let's open up one of these images. You can download these images off the internet really easily. If you just Google Zoom backgrounds, you're going to find a bunch of them. Some of them are paid, some of them are not. Let's go ahead and step back into my office. Here I am in my office, but as I move, look at what happens. So you can see how parts of me disappear and the background keeps kind of coming and going. Now, if I had long flowing hair, it would be even more problematic because hair is one of the hardest parts for a virtual green screen to properly map. Essentially, your computer is pretending that the image behind you is all green, which it's not. So you can see how clunky this looks. This is without a green screen. I'm gonna go ahead and turn it back off again. Here I am back in my actual bedroom. Let's go ahead and put the green screen back up. Super easy to do. We'll just take the pole, get it locked into place, grab the screen, pull it up. Now let's go ahead and turn my office background back on. There it is. But this time, I'm going to check the box that says I have a green screen. Like that, and like that. And now, you can't really tell that it's completely fake. It's just a background. And it's a background that I can change at will. But once you really start to understand the functionality of a green screen, it's going to benefit you not just when you're on Zoom, but when you're in other apps as well. For example, maybe you shoot YouTube videos. And you don't want everybody to know that you're shooting them in your bedroom. And it's that easy to fix it. And that's our lesson for today. different ways you can use green screens, what it looks like when you put an image on a green screen, what it looks like when you don't really have a green screen, but you tell your program to make a virtual green screen. There are all these different options and all these different choices, and what you use for yourself and your video situation might be different than anything I've used. If you've got some other pointers, thoughts, questions, drop them in the comments section down below. And if you got some great value out of this lesson, make sure you give it a thumbs up so that other people can find this video as well. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, now's your chance. Go ahead and click the subscribe button and check that little bell so that you always get notified when we post new videos. I'm Dylan Stewart. I'm the Mac Whisperer. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.